Welcome to Off Limits, everybody. Thanks for joining me for my 200th episode on BTR. I appreciate you joining me for this episode, if you're listening live or in the archives or wherever you are. I have started the show in late 2010 and have done 200 Blog Talk radio shows as of this show. So on Off Limits, we talked about everything over the past few years, everything from politics to religion, racism, gay and lesbian rights, homophobia, friendships, relationships, everything and everything in between, and a little music thrown in as well. So I have had the pleasure of doing this show for this time, and I have been very happy to do it. It's been something that I really have enjoyed for the most part, the show itself anyway, and have really come to realize that it is a that it has, after putting together these clips I'm going to play from you from all those previous 200 shows I've done, not all of the shows, but a few clips from the previous 200 shows, that really I think that this show does serve a purpose and people do appreciate its message. And you can take from what I'm going to play for you tonight what message you want from the previous shows we've had, previous discussions. But first we're going to start with something that I've talked a lot about on the Off Limits show, and that's politics. And going to play you a few clips about politics and see how things have progressed politically on the show in time and see what you think.
I thought there was a station of a bunch of Republicans always got something to say about the gay lifestyle, but every time you turn on the news, one of them falling out the closet.
Exactly.
So what they need to do, since Obama passed that law and says okay to be gay and all, they can come on out now and be who they
are. I agree.
There's so many of them, so they need to come on out and put the, you know, stop hating, you know, because every time you turn on the TV, one of them falling out the closet. America in chains. Get over who y'all think this country should be, because there's a new world in this country today. And you ignorant folks going to burn in hell. They like starting wars. They like doing everything against human life. Every time you turn on the TV, to me, this new Republican that's coming out 2011, them some of the ignorant people. And I ain't never thought I would see that much ignorance coming out this country 2011.
Sarah Palin, for example, the moron. Huckabee's a moron, an asshole. I mean, there's so many of these Republicans who are coming out to be voted into the next, you know, election that it's quite scary, but I really don't find any of them remotely good candidates to be president. I don't think any of them would win against Obama, but you never know.
They ain't going to win. See, they lose in their mind because they don't want to see the world change.
So I remember that caller. That caller was one of my earlier shows from, I think, the first or second year I was doing the show, and he was very adamant that this country really isn't ever going to change when it comes to politics. And I think he's right. I mean, if you look at back on what's happened since then, of course, you could debate that. In some ways, obviously, we've had some political change in the country since then, but we certainly think politics are played as usual when it comes to politics in America. So not a lot has changed. But of course, Obama has done a lot for the gay community, and of course, we recently had a lot of talk about the overturning of DOMA, et cetera. So of course, there's been many changes here in the country, but you know, things do stay the same to some degree when you think about it. Things really don't change that much altogether. But we've talked about politics on the show a lot, but the things that we talk about the most on Off Limits typically are gay topics, and also of course religion and racism and bigotry. So I'm going to play several clips of what some shows we had regarding the idea that, you know, there is bigotry in this country to a great degree, and there still is and always has been and always will be. But we've dealt with bigotry on many shows and many different topics on Off Limits throughout the years. So here are a few clips from some people who've called in regarding their ideas on bigotry.
Like completely like completely in awe of how much hatred there is. And you know, most people here on the show or on Blog Talk Radio have been pretty cool, and but it's like a sea of straight people, which, you know, that's my daily life, and that's okay. But you know, yeah, thank you, Blue Sky. I said, what if I'm gay? I agree. Big fucking deal, right? But unfortunately, a lot of people make a huge deal out of it, especially on here. Well, I mean, I was in the room, and this Tracy Gamore, I think's her name, or G Moore, she goes by that. She's all, you know, you're a faggot, and you're a Peter Puffer, and all this kind of stuff. And the funny thing is, it doesn't really bother me because it just shows her stupidity and ignorance. And but you know, she's totally like jumping all over me because I'm gay. And I'm like, you know, look, bitch, I didn't say anything to you. You just come in here and start attacking me because you don't like the fact that I'm gay, you know? And basically, you know, most people who hate gay people, it's because their religious beliefs or whatever, and that's a whole other topic, which I actually talked about on one of my shows. If you go to my website, offlimitshow.com, you can listen to it in the archives. But and I had a call in from Constantine from Abilene. I think he's on here a lot. And we had a discussion for about an hour back and forth, a phone call, about being gay and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, so, but, you know, so I'm just kind of tired of it. And I thought I'd get on here and just kind of chat a little bit with people and let people know me a little bit better, let people know my personality and that kind of thing, and kind of see what I'm about. But, you know, I'm you know, I live in Texas, and Texas is a really conservative state. And, I mean, we have a governor in Texas, Rick Perry, who said, if you're gay, if you don't like it, you can get the fuck out, basically. He didn't say that, but he said, if you're gay, you can move. I don't care. So, you know, it gets kind of tiring, and I get kind of sick of it, but whatever. But do you guys want...
So there's another clip about bigotry that we've had. So I've got several other clips on bigotry that I'm going to play over the years, two or three more that I want you to hear, especially about the time I've had on BTR. BTR has been one of the most bigoted places I've ever experienced online or anywhere in my entire life towards gay people, towards people of different races or religions or anything other than the white Anglo-Saxon heterosexual Protestant male. So let's hear some more about that. About closet cases and who may or may not be a closet case on BTR. So we're going to announce tonight, we're going to out some people. Just so few people know, and I typically don't advocate outing, but I have to say that in the case of people who are actually preaching hatred and calling people names and, you know, against their own kind, you've got to kind of out those people, okay? It's like the politicians, right? The politicians whom we have been caught, like there's like 10 in the past year or whatever, who were caught in bathrooms and who were gay. And yet who voted against all gay rights and gay marriage and gay policies of any kind. So that's hypocritical to me. I think it's horrible. And so I think we should discuss who is and who isn't gay on Blog Talk Radio. Now, we'll start with myself. I have to announce to everyone listening tonight that I, iconoclast, I am a homosexual. I am gay. I know it's a surprise. But I have to tell you all that I am. I have been since I was born. I have been openly gay since I was 14 years old. And I thought it was time for everyone else to know on BTR that I, yes, am in fact a homosexual male. So that's the first one. The next one on the list would be Lee, I think is his name, CFGA. The next would be USMC Bob. Then we have Black Conservative and Ranger 75. So these are the people that are what I would call on the down low. Why do I say they're on the down low? And they are definitely closet cases. So I was obviously being sarcastic, but obviously that is another example. So then there's a caller we had that said they hate gays. Let's see what they had to say about that.
And the thing is, people often say, oh, well, it's not, I don't hate gay people. I don't hate gay people. I just don't believe in them having equal rights. I said this at the beginning of the show. I don't hate gay people, but I don't believe in them having equal rights. I don't hate gay people, but I don't believe in gay marriage. I don't hate gay people, but I think they should be, they're going to hell. I don't hate gay people, but I think they should, someone should slit their throat because they're wrong or they're morally and inaccurate or something. I don't hate people, gay people, but I don't. I think that they're less important to the world than a heterosexual. I don't hate gay people, but gay sex is inferior to heterosexual sex. I don't hate gay people, but they can't adopt children. I don't hate gay people, but. That's all I fucking hear all the time. But. You know, usually when somebody says but, I don't know where I heard this quote, but usually when somebody says the word but, everything they said in front of but is bullshit. And
all right, so I'm going to play a clip in a moment that my mom, when my mom called into this show a couple of years ago, I did a show on racism, and since my mother was married and in love with a black man, she was Caucasian, and I asked her about what her experience was on that. But before I play that, I wanted to play a clip, recent clip from a show I did on the issue of racism regarding, or bigotry in general, regarding Paula Deen and her issues with being fired from the food network, et cetera. And I had a caller, her name's Bathtub Girl, that's what she goes from BTR, who called in, and this is what she had to say, and I had to say back.
Hey.
Hi, who's this?
Hey, it's BTG. I was listening to you, and I'm thinking of the different race relations. The race relations, you know, all the different things. I think you can be guilty, but not responsible. You can be guilty for what our forefathers have done, but not responsible. There comes a time when, you know, the no white guilt does come into play. I think people are oversensitive. Paula's Paula, right? Isn't she entitled to her own opinions as long as she's not inflicting pain intentionally on another? I think we have a black woman that was just oversensitive.
Okay, stop. You're saying that it's okay for Paula to say nigger or use nigger jokes around a black man in her presence because that's how she feels and it's her opinion. And that the black woman is just being oversensitive. Is that what you're saying to me?
Yeah, I think she might be oversensitive, or is.
Okay, now why do you think she's being oversensitive?
Well, because in today's society, there's all different types of racial jokes.
Why do you think it's okay? Why do you think it's okay for anybody to say a racial joke, a nigger joke, if you want to call it, a fag joke, if you want to call it, whatever, in front of that particular minority and not expect them necessarily possibly to be offended. Whether they're offended or not is not the point. The point is that for someone to do it around someone else is ridiculous. It does cause her harm, cause her emotional harm and emotional distress. So yes, it does cause
harm. Yeah, major market radio station, and I was only one of two white people that were at that station, and I heard so many white jokes, just so many jokes about women that were in very poor taste.
And that's not right.
Jokes about white people.
And that's not right.
I,